Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic homolytic fission in covalent bond. Hello friends, we know that for a reaction to happen, that is a bond fission should be occurred, and because of which only the reactant will get divided because of its the bond breaking, and then the only thing that is being done is because of the bond formation we could get the product. So now this bond fission are basically divided into two parts, that is homolytic fission and heterolytic fission. So now we are going to do a topic which is based on that is homolytic fission. So what is that? Let us understand it. So now let us understand what is actually homolytic fission. So before understanding it, we should know what is the definition of it. So therefore it says that the symmetrical breaking of a covalent bond between the two atoms such that each atom acquires one electron of the shared pair is called as homolytic fission. So let me give an example in this case, and then only it would be very much clear to understand that is what is actually homolytic fission. Suppose if we have a reactant like this one. So this is the reactant that we have, and for which we know that the bond should break, but the bond will break in such a manner, because when you are talking about homolytic fission, so as we could see that these two electrons are being equally shared by this A as well as this atom B. So this are being equally shared by the two electrons. That's the reason that it is forming a covalent bond over here, as you could see over here. But what if the bond breaks? So in this case, basically, when the bond will break, then according to the homolytic fission, the bond will break in such a manner that the electron, each atom will get its own electron. So that is the reason that if the bond will break, we could get A electron and this is B electron, B atom which is acquiring its electron. So now if we read the definition again, so therefore this is a symmetrical breaking of a covalent bond between the two atoms such that each atom acquires one electron of its shared pair. So that's the reason now A is the atom which has been acquiring a electron when this has been divided symmetrically, means the bond has been divided symmetrically. So if I notice this thing, then I could obtain the product to be that of the radicals. So these are the radicals that we have obtained. So radicals are those species, or basically the most reactive species, in which it consists of its electron, and that is not carbocation nor a carboanion. That is when it comes to, we have did a topic which is based on carbocation, which was nothing but the hyperconjugation of a carbocation, and in this case this radical species are basically more reactive species, and they are very short living species. But the thing is, this reactive species plays a very important role in the formation of a product, because in this case we have only involved only one reactant, that is AB. And but suppose if the other reactant, suppose like CD, is been involved, so therefore we could get the possible product, and due to which the radical has been formed, and now after that it will react with the other radicals so as to get a product. So now let me again come back to that is what is homolytic fission. So therefore this is the symmetrical division of the bond in such a manner that each electron acquires its one electron, and but the representation is very important. So we represent it with that is fish hook arrows. So this is what we represent by fish hook. So this we have did a lecture on the representation of the breaking of the bond also, and as well as we have also mentioned the movement of the electrons. So in that case we have got to know that this fish hook is the one which represents that the electrons are being distributed to their respective atoms symmetrically, and that's the reason that we will find this kind of product as radical. So now talking about the next one, that is where we could see the formation of radicals, or where we could see the homolytic fission. And basically we could see that suppose if the both the atoms that are being involved to form a molecule or that are a molecule like that of, I would say, like Cl2. So if we see the electronegativity, because both the atoms are the same, so therefore the electronegativity of the both of them will also be the same. That's the reason when the bond will get break, then the homolytic fission will happen, or we could say that this is the homolytic fission that we are talking about, in such a manner that each chlorine will acquire its electron while forming a chlorine radicals. So this is because the both the atoms are having the same electronegativity, and hence there is no kind of bias that the one of the atom will acquire the both of the electron towards itself, and this is what the homolytic fission is. So not only in terms of the chlorine that we have mentioned over here, we could also means chlorine was an example where we could find that the chlorine is electronegative, but we could also give an example of that is CH3. And CH3, that is ethane. Even ethane, when undergone through an homolytic fission, we could get the radicals like CH3 and CH3. But we should also indicate the representation that with the fish hook arrows over here, as I have mentioned over here. So this indicates that the electron has been distributed symmetrically, and that is what we could get. But this kind of homolytic fission is possible if we provide heat or if we provide UV light. So that is the only reason that it will form that is homolytic fission, because both of these atoms that are been involved in the that are in the molecule, as you could see. So because of the sunlight or because of the high temperature, if you provide, then only they will form the radicals, or then only the homolytic fission will happen. Suppose if the particular reactant is to be reacted with a particular in a particular solvent, then in this case of homolytic fission, we keep the reactants in that is non-polar solvents. So therefore, this all the examples that I have mentioned over here. So this all is possible if we take a non-polar solvent and in which the reaction would occur. So that was it. I wanted to explain about the homolytic fission. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. And I hope you will share this video with the friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.